Daniels,
yes,
for her husband.
As married.
founder of the R&B group Brownstone, one of my favorite female groups ever. I'm having a fangirl moment. I remember driving around Atlanta in my convertible blasting If You Love Me.
That was it.
You have just done a brilliant job of sort of making the transition from just music to television and production. And was that something you always planned, or did you just say, you know what, as you said in our interview earlier on television, that this isn't going the way I want, so maybe I need to look at something else for a minute?
You know, in my life, I wanted to actually act first. Mm-hmm. I wanted to be, you know, most people are like, oh, you know, I've always wanted to sing. That was my first passion. My mom was a singer. My dad was a Motown writer. So music was a little like, they've done that. I don't want to do that. But it happened first for me.
Yeah.
So, you know, I have to say it was my first passion. But I really wanted to transition and really have a larger platform, and not just a larger platform. I wanted to show all aspects of who I am. I'm a multi-hyphenate, so mm-hmm. I'm like a singer, an actress, a writer, a, you know, producer, the whole nine. So I wanted to make sure, and I felt like music was something I had done.
Yeah.
She did that. So, you know, let's do something different.
Mm-hmm. Was it hard?
To
get started doing
it? Yeah, it was very hard. It was hard because most people wanted me to just shut up and sing.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It's just like, you're a singer.
Yeah.
So all this other stuff you over here doing.
They wanted to pigeonhole you.
Right, exactly. So I did an episode of Martin, was one of the first things that I had done.
I did
where I played somebody who couldn't sing for a minute, right?
Yes.
And then I did, and it was very important for me to not play a singer. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? So
yeah.
I wanted to just explore other creative, you know, ideas, and I love writing and producing. I would say my first love and my passion over all things is my ability to write.
I mean, and nobody can take that away from you, really. And do you envision, like, I would say you had a huge music career. Do you wake up at night and you think, when I win that Emmy and that Oscar, and that, you know, do you plan that far ahead?
I do. you got to speak it into existence, or okay, it won't happen for you. Not to take anything away. I mean, we signed a deal with Michael Jackson. I mean, mm-hmm. how many people in the world can
say you mentioned that
they got a record deal with Michael Jackson? So I'm very, very grateful for that. But, and we've been nominated for a Grammy, so, you know, I'd still like to win one. That would be perfect.
Yes. Can I ask you, did you work with Michael Jackson?
Okay, so here's the thing. Now, we worked with him from the perspective of, you know, it was his label, mm-hmm. and he heard all of the music and had to approve everything. But what I love and respect most about Michael is that he allowed us to just be creative and be who we were. And when he discovered that we were writers and it was self-contained, he just let us go. And I remember one of the most powerful things that anybody's ever said to me is, we did this, it was one of those music conventions. And I remember just being so nervous. We were getting ready to take a picture, and I remember being super nervous, and I was like, oh my God, I'm so nervous. He's like, why are you nervous? We signed you because you're great. Be great. Put that energy into being greater, not being nervous.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh my God, Michael Jackson said something to me. You know, and it stuck with me forever. So
look, if Michael Jackson said it, then it's so, right?
He's the king.
Especially when it comes to entertaining and singing and writing. And I think that's being able to let somebody, recognizing the talent in somebody's voice, not just the musical talent, but the ability to write and everything, and letting them be them. Mm-hmm. You know, that's that is confidence in yourself. And also, you have that gift of knowing what's, you know, what true talent is.
And to get that validation was like, okay, yeah, mm-hmm, we're all right.
You have a wonderful, strong, this powerful voice.
Thank you so much.
And I'm glad that you are using it to do some other things that you love and calling attention to important issues.
I'm really excited about just using my voice and my platform to truly help enrich the lives of people in our community, because I think that's why God gives us these gifts.
Yes.
So that we can share, you know, the truth, but also inspiration and love. And that's what I'm here for.
Yeah, and you are definitely using Nikki Gilbert Daniels for your husband.
Yes.
Thank you so much for spending a little time with us.
Thank you.